Hi guys, I'm just eating my dinner. I have brown stewed chicken. Mustard greens, and rice with a little broccoli in there, and that's what's for dinner.
I don't really want to do nothing. I don't want to go out. I don't want to do nothing. I just want to be inside.
How you doing?
Body twins. 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 Body.
Today, we have some lamb chops. Okay, we have some lamb chops. This is gonna be my second time trying them. This is gonna be your first. Okay? We also have some cauliflower mash and some asparagus around the background here. I hope y'all can see them, y'all. I know y'all probably won't be able to see them, girl. Girl, they're green. You already know the green screen washes out anything that's green. Well, but anyway, let's hear our voice, girl.
God is good. God is great. Let us thank you for our food. Amen. And listen, before we dive into this scrumptious meal, girl, make sure y'all grab the snack and come on right on back, girl.
You already know.
You already know.
Hope you guys are having an amazing week.
You let me meow. You let me meow.
Craig, you're going to taste out this taste reading.
This is so good.
It gives me steak, girl. Are you steak cousin?
It gives you mini steak. Yes.
Okay. So can we eat?
But yes.
What are we trying first? I want to try this.
You want to try that?
Yeah, I just want to pick it up like this.
Or you just want to pick it up and bite it, girl?
I just want to pick it up and bite it. Pick it up and bite it.
Because these little ones give you like oxtails.
Is that mini?
Okay.
How you doing?
Take a bite, girl.
Let me show it to him. Ooh, y'all see that? Ooh, y'all see that? Y'all see this lamb chop?
Hey, lamb, lamb. Hey, lammy.
So, yeah, first I fried this. Then I put it in the oven so it can get juicy and nice.
Okay.
Now, this is the one that I wanted initially. I wanted the one that had the bone that comes like this.
Oh.
the loin area, but it's still lamb chops though.
I want some goat meat.
Okay, lamb girl, lamb chop girl, I see you lamb.
Have you ever tried goat meat? It tastes like beef, but with a zing, if you know what I mean. It has like this really strong aftertaste. But it's good. I watch a few mukbangers on YouTube when they eat. I've been watching them and following them for a while. And I am a very big fan of Beloved's Life, the Batty Twins. I love Simply Food by T.Y. Okay.
I wonder if the other one tastes the same.
I love
Cause that's the other one that I have. Yeah, the one with the longer.
What's his name? Nikocado, avocado. He be getting
okay,
it in.
Okay, y'all, so the PVO for today goes like this.
I love Chilling with Walt.
For every reason.
He's down to earth and very funny to me.
For every reason, it's not
and
possible.
Who else?
There are hundreds of people who have faced the same circumstances, and succeeded.
There was another one
for
I forgot.
Reason, mm-mm. Delete this. Delete this. What is coming up? For every reason, it's not possible. There are hundreds of people who have faced the same circumstances.
I love, what is his name? Zach Choi.
Message.
I love him.
Yes, ma'am.
He also be getting it in.
And with that being said, guys, I want to talk to y'all about something. So I have been in a little bit of a funk.
I think that's it. Oh, did I say the Batty Twins?
So
I love them. They're so funny.
I think I have it like once a year where I just feel like, I don't want to say depressed, but it's kind of like I'm a little bit depressed. Like I don't really want to do nothing. I don't want to go out. I don't want to do nothing. I just want to be inside. And I don't know. It kind of comes from when you have certain goals for yourself, and if you don't achieve them in a certain time, then you feel like you're not doing your best, or you just feel down on yourself. And I have those times like probably at least once a year. It used to be more severe back in the day, but as I grow older and I achieve more goals, it kind of goes away. But when I tell you guys that depression is real, so I have been kind of in my funk, not really want to go anywhere.
Excuse me.
Guys. But I'm slowly coming out of it. I think also another part of it is that I've been trying to lose some weight, and I haven't seen a lot of results yet. And that's partially because I haven't really been going in as hard as I know that I really can go in. So I'm supposed to be blamed for that, so I just need to work harder to get my results. But I have been in kind of a funk because of that also. also. But you know what? People go through a lot of stuff, and you just gotta put out the extra work to get the results. And that's what I'm gonna do, y'all.
As long as you don't stay in that funk for too long. Like, be in your bag, sis, but don't be in your bag all year. You know what I'm saying?
Girl, it's only been a month.
No, I'm just saying, I'm not saying you. I'm just saying in general.
So, yeah, and then with me now, when I'm kind of in my funk, I don't really want to be around other people because I don't want to, like...
The energy.
Yeah, I don't want to give off the wrong energy and make them think that probably, like, I'm a bitch or I don't know how to have fun or stuff like that. But sometimes you just want to be by yourself. I don't know if it's a Taurus thing. If y'all could relate, comment down below. I know it's a Taurus thing, but sometimes I just want to be alone. And I don't want to be bothered at all. And I'm not being mean or rude. I just want my space.
That's just how you feel.
Mm-hmm.
There's some days I get up and I just feel like there's no particular reason, but you just feel like you just need to be to yourself and you don't want to be bothered or annoyed.
Uh-huh. Even the people that you love, you don't want to be around. Mm-hmm. That's just how it is sometimes.
Sometimes it's just not even an attitude thing. It's just how you feel. Mm-hmm. You know? It's a lamb chop for me, though, bro.
It is. And that's on Mary having a little lamb chop.
I kind of like to marry that mutton, girl. It's
because mutton can be, mutton can taste like it's over-seasoned sometimes. But this is more like...
Bro, this is good. Because
it's kind of like mutton, but she's a little bit more pricey, girl. She's pricey, girl.
Is she a delicacy?
Maybe. She's probably an upper echelon.
You know what? You gotta know.
Oh, yeah. So talking about depression, when I tell you that depression is so real, I watched the Demi Lovato documentary on YouTube. So she released part one and part two. So if y'all don't know who Demi Lovato is, she's a singer, and she almost died because she over a drug overdose because she was from depression.
Heroin and something.
Yes. She almost died. She was like five to 10 minutes away from dying. If her assistant didn't go by her house and find her, she would have been dead.
The scary part about all of it, though, is none of her friends knew that she had an addiction. Like, she knew how to hide it.
Yeah.
Like, she would literally be around her. She was happy and having fun. But then when they leave, she would go to drugs, and you would never
know. And a lot of people know how to do that, too. A lot of people know how to hide
it. How to hide
it. You might never know. And let me tell y'all this too. Not everybody that's taking drugs looks bad because she don't look like nothing happened to her. Her nose don't look different. She still have her teeth. She don't look like she lost weight. Her skin don't look anywhere. She look natural to me. And to be almost lose her life and to almost she had a little bit of brain damage, so she was blind at one point. Girl, she was blind.
Girl.
All I can say here is she better get down on her knees and pray every day because she's really blessed.
That's only God.
Yeah. Because from what they were saying, she should have been dead.
And it's so sad because she called over her dealer.
These birds just creep up on you.
And he took advantage of her and raped her.
That goes to say that depression doesn't have nothing to do with wealth, doesn't have nothing to do with materialistic things. You can have everything in the world and still be depressed over something. It can be either, whether it be your weight, whether it be just your mentality, or even if you're very successful, you always want to achieve something else. So even if it's you stressing,
I love brown stew chicken.
Or losing a family member.
I don't remember if I did a video cooking that.
So it don't matter. Anybody can.
But if I haven't, go to any Caribbean YouTuber channel and see how to cook brown stew Caribbean style chicken.
At least
It is superb. It tastes so good. And it's colored with brown sugar. I give it 2 thumbs up. Try it. Like this video, share, subscribe so you can get notified when I upload another video, divas and devos. Enjoy your Saturday night. I know I will. Watching YouTubers, mukbang, cooking shows. I do everything that makes me feel good, to make me smile. Anywho, enjoy your night, and I'll see you again soon. Okay? God bless. Love you. Mean it.